This is the online service of St. Rose of Lima Parish, located in Newtown, Connecticut.
And in the Mass we receive our Lord, and He is present with us in our hearts. You know, later on tonight we're going to have adoration, and the priest is going to walk around with Jesus. It's such a powerful and such a life-changing moment. Right now in Mass, we like literally get to hold them in our hearts and receive them. You know, it's as if, you know, when Jesus was walking by tonight in adoration, if the priest just stopped, took the host out and gave him to you. So often we missed out on what it is that's going on here before us in the Mass. So let's just pray those words for 2 seconds and say, Holy Spirit, you're welcome here.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome.
Come flood this place.
Come flood this place and fill the air.
Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence.
To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Let's sing that again. And as we do again, just make it a prayer for today, for what we're doing now.
Test.
Holy
Test
Spirit,
one, two.
You're welcome here. This is a time of thanksgiving, time to come and rejoice in the Lord. And we're going to just take a minute here. And instead, you know, very often when we come before our God, we're like, God, I need this, I need that, and the other thing, and hold on, where's my list? And you just go through the whole thing. For this Mass, we're just going to be thankful. I want you to take a moment to think honestly for something that you're really, really thankful for. And maybe it's going to be hard to find something that's thankful. Because sometimes our lives can be a disaster. But we all have at least one thing to be thankful for. Just place it on the altar. In our opening song for this morning is going to be Alleluia, Sing to Jesus, which can be found in your song books right in front of you. Number 732. Number 732 is a lot to use song books. So why don't we stand?
Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My friends, as we gather today to ask the fire of the Holy Spirit to come upon you and me, we begin this celebration of the sacred mysteries, calling to mind our sins as we turn to the Lord for his pardon.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, our Father, who sanctify your universal church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of your Spirit across the face of the earth, so that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are in the flesh cannot please God. But you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit. If only the Spirit of God dwells in you, whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the Spirit is alive because of righteousness. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh to live accordingly to the flesh. For if you live accordingly to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to the death the deeds of the body, you will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption. Though whom we cry, Abba, Father, the Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if only we suffer with him so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response is, Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O the Lord, my God, you are great indeed. You are clothed with majesty and glory, robed in light as with a cloak. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. How manifold are your works, O Lord. In wisdom you have wrought them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Alleluia. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. Creatures all look to you to give them food in due time. When you give it to them, they gather it. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your Spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Hallelujah.
Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you all. Considering the weather that we have, I'm very grateful that you're here to spend this day in prayer and reflection to receive, please God, a great gift. A gift that you need and I need in our lives of faith. But allow me to offer to you a question. A question that I want you to reflect upon today, and when you go home and back to school and all the rest in the weeks ahead, I want you to keep this question in the back of your mind. Because the answer to the question makes all the difference in the world. What are you, my friends, what am I willing to pay as a price to follow Jesus? Maybe ask the question another way. How far are you and I willing to walk with Jesus to remain faithful to him? On the surface, it sounds like almost a simple question. You would say, well, Bishop, if I were not here, the fact that I'm here, I do want to follow Jesus, and rightfully so, we all do. And yet, is it not true that the more we walk with him, at times the more he asks of us, that the road is not always smooth and easy, sometimes it's challenging, and sometimes we don't necessarily want to pay the price for that next step, that next decision. So I ask you again, what price are you willing to pay to follow the Lord Jesus? It is a question, my friends, every believer needs to ask over and over again. It is a question that was asked from the beginning. In the early church, every Christian who followed Jesus could answer that question by saying, "I will give Jesus everything, even my life," because to be a Christian was a crime and the penalty was death. And they followed him by the tens of thousands. Yesterday we honored one, Lawrence, the deacon, who literally was put to death. He was literally burned alive because he dared to follow Jesus. And it was true then, as it is true in more recent history. Teresa Benedicta of the Cross, Edith Stein, another martyr whom we celebrated 2 days ago, gave her life at the hands of the Holocaust because of her faith in Christ. Please God, we will never have to do that. You and I will never have to do that. But he will ask for a lot. You and I, you know, we live in a world that has very little room for God or Jesus. You know that better than I do. You know, we live in a world that's really more concerned about oneself than our neighbor. Isn't it true we live in a world that doesn't want to talk about peace, but wants to talk about division and polarization? a world that's much more concerned about what makes us different than what unites us. And the list goes on and on and on. You don't need me to tell you all that. And living in that world, swimming in that ocean, it is very hard at times not to drink the Kool-Aid. Not to follow what everyone else is saying, doing, thinking, or whispering in your ear and mine. So let me be blunt, because I love you, and because I love you, I'm going to be blunt, like any good father. Jesus is going to ask you and me to stand up for the truth and to say it clearly in word and action. For you and I know what he wants of us, to love God above all things and to love our neighbor as ourselves. He is going to ask you and me to be his hands and feet in the world, his heart, to be the one person perhaps among all others who will be the understanding one, the forgiving one, the one who will be patient and kind, because wherever there is love, there is God, as St. John tells us. He will also ask us, you and me, to go where others will not want to go, to seek out that one classmate that nobody likes and nobody gets along with, to seek out that one person in your neighborhood who has been desperately trying to find someone to be a friend and is really looking for you to be that person. The Lord is asking you and me, in faith, hope, and charity, to be his missionary in the world. A world which may not always want it, may not always welcome it. That's the cost, the price to pay. Now you may say, well, Bishop, I do want to do those things. I certainly want to do those things. But we sometimes fail. So what is it, is the gift God wishes to give you? That is why you are here today, my friends, because our theme today is be courageous. And that is the one gift God has already given you that is for the asking. In your baptism, in your confirmation, it is the gift of the Holy Spirit that is lying in your heart to allow you to do everything I have just said one day at a time. You do not have to be a believer to be courageous. People are courageous for many reasons, to do the things they dare could not imagine doing before. But what I'm talking about is to be courageous for the sake of Christ and the sake of the gospel. That is, to dare to do, to say, and go to places that we would not ordinarily do on our own power, because it is Christ who will lead us there. It was Christ who will inspire us, Christ who will stand with us, Christ who will give us the word to speak, Christ who will never abandon us. It will be Christ's Spirit that will allow you to do what you could never imagine doing before. And that, my friends, is the gift of courage, to persevere in what you and I know is right, even when it hurts. And we are not perfect. I am a sinner, and so are you. And we have failed at times. But what I want you to consider is to be encouraged, because you, in the Spirit, can be that missionary. You can do what the Lord is asking. You can pay any price he asks, because he will help you every step of the way. I am looking into the faces of young women and men who are destined to be great, courageous disciples of Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit will help you. So what is my request of you today? In your song, in your fraternity, at your meals, during your talks, whatever you do today and in the weeks ahead, don't be afraid to ask for that gift, specifically to grow in your hearts, to do what you know and already believe is the right thing to do. And I promise you, you will be amazed at what God will be able to do in you. Let me end by offering you one brief story. I already mentioned St. Lawrence, who was the deacon who died in the middle of the 3rd century because of his faith. When Lawrence's pope also was murdered for his faith, St. Lawrence knew he would be next. So he did what I consider to be an extraordinary thing. He took all his money, all his possessions, everything. He even sold some of the vessels in the church, and he gathered all that money and gave it to all the poor and sick and disabled in the city of Rome where he lived. Now, the prefect of Rome heard about this and called Lawrence in, and he said, "So I understand you're a rich man. I understand that you have all these monies that you are giving away. Give it to me. Give to me the treasure of the church, and I'll spare your life." Lawrence said, "Give me a few days to prepare, and I will be back." And a few days, Lawrence went back to the prefect, and he brought with him the poor and the sick and the disabled of Rome in the hundreds. And as he entered into the presence of the prefect, he turned to him and said, "Look upon the treasure of the church." And not short after, Lawrence was put to death. Do you know what, my friends? History has no idea of the name of that Roman prefect, because in the end, he could not see what Lawrence sees. But Lawrence, we remember, because he had the courage to live what he believed. And my prayer for you, my friends, is that one day, years from now, there will be young people sitting in this beautifully newly expanded church. They will be in this church years from now, remembering your name because of the courageous faith you had in Jesus. My friends, as always, when we gather in the Eucharist, let us turn to God our Father. Let us remember our own needs, and let us also remember the needs of the entire world.
For Pope Francis, all bishops, priests, and religious, that they may be strengthened by the grace of the Holy Spirit to continue proclaiming the truth of the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all politicians and world leaders, that the spirit of wisdom and compassion guide them in all their decisions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, that the spirit of healing bring peace and comfort to their hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit would strengthen the faith of all gathered here at Fan the Fire, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit may bring all our departed loved ones into the fullness of God's presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, as we gather for this day of grace, we ask that your Holy Spirit inflame our hearts with courage to persevere in the works that you have given us to do. For we make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
There's nothing worth more that will ever come close.
There's nothing worth more. Thank you.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
May the fire of the Spirit, O Lord, sanctify the sacrificial gifts offered in your sight, just as it enkindled the hearts of the disciples of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. for you bestow gifts suited to every season and guide the governing of your church in wonderful ways. By the power of the Holy Spirit, you come unfailingly to her aid, so that with a heart always subject to you, she may never fail to seek your help in time of trouble, nor cease to give you thanks in time of joy through Christ our Lord. And so in the company of the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Lord, that's all Lord. And profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Frank, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
My friends, may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
Christ, peace be with you. Bob, peace be with you. Crystal, peace be with you. Peace be with you, Henry. Harry, peace be with you. Stephen, peace be with you. John, peace. Peace be with you, David. Peter, peace. Peace be with you, Joe. Bob, peace be with you. Andy, peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Communion song is Here I Am, Lord, can be found in number 379, 379, Here I Am, Lord.
shadow.
Snow shadow, you won't light up. Mountain, you won't climb up. Coming after me. Snow wall, you won't kick down. A lie, you won't tear down. Coming after me.
Snow shadow, you won't light up.
Snow shadow, you won't light mountain up. Mountain, you won't climb up. Coming after me.
Snow wall, you won't kick down.
Snow wall, you won't kick down. A lie, you won't tear down. Coming after me.
Snow shadow, you won't light up.
Snow shadow, you won't light up. Mountain, you won't climb up. Coming after me.
Snow wall, you won't kick down.
Snow wall, you won't kick down. Lie, you won't tear down. Coming after me.
The overwhelming.
Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, finds till I'm found, leaves the 99. I couldn't earn it, I don't deserve.
Let us pray.
May these gifts we have consumed benefit us, O Lord, that we may always be aflame with the same Spirit whom you wondrously poured out upon your apostles. For we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The same Lord that we received, who came into you and me a few moments ago, is now before us here, the Blessed Sacrament. And as you know, we'll have adoration later on in the day. He comes to encourage you and me, for he will never leave us. He is literally in you and me. So during the day, I presume our Lord will be here all day. If you spend some time here to come back in the midst of everything else going on, you could ask him for that gift in your heart and mine, that we may always be encouraged to the end. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
Before we offer the final hymn, I'm going to ask you to kneel, so I may reverence the Blessed Sacrament, and then we will leave with the closing
singing our closing song, number 606, Your Grace Is Enough, number 606.
Thank you.
You got this. Come on. I know you know this song.
Come on, church.
Awesome, awesome,
This is the online service of St. Rose of Lima Parish, located in Newtown, Connecticut.